War. War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself, for my wife, for my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes. War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hun.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
Hey, my turn, big guy.
Let me just slide in here.
You have such a strong chin.
I clean up pretty nice.
I like it. Makes you look younger.
What do you think, hon? Roguishly handsome or handsomely roguish?
You look as good as the day we met.
Well, hello, handsome.
You have great lips. You know that?
Hun, you think my nose is too big?
I love that face.
Yeah, not bad.
Such a cute nose.
Looking good, if I do say so myself.
Mustache. Very cool.
Not bad. Not bad.
I like the scruff. It accents your chin.
Hey, hon.
Why don't you see if breakfast is ready?
Ah, good morning, sir. Your coffee. 173.5 degrees Fahrenheit. Room 2.